Hi guys, welcome back. Welcome to the second part of my previously uploaded video, which was on the lines of the usage pattern and the user pattern behavior of every human being possible on living on earth. And I'm not here to, you know, let some gyan out ki kab use karna chahiye, kab use nahi karna chahiye. But then I thought that there is two specific timelines in our day. One is, you know, right when we wake up, and one is right before we go to sleep. These two timelines, they really have a major and a drastic impact on our day-to-day lives, and it has a drastic impact on our mental and physical health. So, इस दौरान ये दो timelines में हम जो करते हैं या नहीं करते, that really has an impact on ourselves. So, hence I thought that, you know, I'd probably make two videos, part one and part two, and let you guys know as to, you know, how harmful or what the consequences are of using electronic devices like smartphones, laptops, or, you know, probably watching TV right before we go to sleep and right after we wake up. So this is part two, guys, and this is going to be on the lines of what happens when we take these digital devices with ourselves to our bed. Now, reason number one being that it directly disrupts your REM cycle. Now, what is REM cycle? For all those people watching this video who do not know what REM cycle is, it is that duration of time from the total time that you sleep, where your sleep is the deepest. It could have gotten a little confusing, so let me give you another perspective. Let's say, for example, on an average, I sleep for about 7 to 8 hours in a day. Now, the entire 8 hours, I might not be in my deepest sleep, right? So out of this 8 hours, let's say probably 4 hours, this time duration is when my sleep is the deepest. But if I'm indulging in activities like, you know, indulging myself with any electronic devices, like scrolling through social media applications, or probably watching a show or movie right before I go to sleep, this hampers my REM cycle. And so much so that it actually reduces the duration. So let's say, for example, my REM cycle earlier was 4 hours. It could also get to the point of 2.5 hours or 3 hours. Now, when your REM cycle reduces, your brain is not really getting the amount of rest that it really deserves, and it is that, and the rest that it is meant to. Now, what happens is, even when you wake up after 7 to 8 hours of sleep, you really find yourself asking these questions ki, yaar, main to itna so gaya, but then why am I feeling groggy? You know, you don't find yourself to be active enough, you don't find yourself to be alert enough, but you're still tired. And you might not even realize that these are the reasons as to why it is happening. Reason number two is on similar lines, but a little different, and it is that it disrupts your circadian rhythm. Now, what is circadian rhythm? Aap keh sakte ho ki it's basically a biological clock. Now, 90 to 95% of the people out there prefer to fall into some kind of a routine. Now, when I say routine, they prefer to, you know, do certain things at a certain time, and so on and so forth. They like to proceed with the day accordingly. Now, let's say, for example, I go to sleep at 11:30 in the night and wake up at 7:30 in the morning. Now, as soon as the clock or the day touches 9 p.m., 9:30, 10, my body automatically realizes that it's evening time, it's getting night time, and, you know, it's been so long that we've been up. It starts putting itself into rest mode. It starts putting itself into recovery mode and sleep mode. Now, if I am experiencing or exposing it to artificial blue light that is emitting right from my smartphone devices or my laptops, the body thinks that it is still not evening, or the body thinks that you know, there is still something that has to be a task that has to be completed or accomplished before I go to sleep. So the body wakes up again from its recovery mode to the active mode, and hence we find ourselves sleeping a little later, tossing and turning into our beds for, you know, 45 minutes or 60 minutes straight. It has happened with me. I mean, I would keep my phone away thinking that in the next 10-15 minutes I would probably go to sleep, but I find myself, you know, looking at the ceiling for the next 1 hour. So it directly has an impact on a circadian clock, and then when the circadian clock gets hampered, it affects the consecutive, the following day as well. Now, the third and the most important reason is, again, it follows from the first two reasons, and once it disrupts the REM cycle and, you know, the circadian clock, the biological rhythm, there is a hormone called melatonin. Now, melatonin is a hormone which is a sleep-induced hormone. Now, again, the body has certain timelines that it follows according to your biological system as to when to, you know, produce these hormones. Now, if the body is getting confused on an everyday single basis and, you know, it's experiencing something new on an everyday basis, your REM cycles are getting affected, your circadian clock is getting affected, the body also gets confused as to when to actually produce melatonin and when to not produce melatonin. And when this cycle is also disrupted, your body starts going through changes on an everyday single basis. So there are times when I know people who probably sleep very less on the weekdays, and then coming weekends, they just sleep the entire weekend out because they are so exhausted by it. They have very disruptive sleep cycles and sleep patterns. Now, this is not something which is very healthy in the longer run and in the long term. So we need to think about, you know, our sleep and our food, what we are eating into our system, as the priority basis, because these two things actually form the foundation of us getting into a healthy and a fit lifestyle. So these are, you know, the most important reasons that I thought I'll come out here, probably make a video and let you guys know as to what is happening. And the last thing that I want to mention is that also please try and refrain from messages or videos or anything, any content that is a little concerning, because subconsciously it is getting registered every now and then. And if you sleep with those thoughts, if you're watching a thriller movie, a horror movie, a murder mystery kind of things, and you're sleeping with those thoughts subconsciously, it is bound to disrupt your dreams. It is bound to generate lucid dreams, vivid dreams, or probably not give you a good quality sleep. So that will be all from my side. I hope you found this video a little helpful, and I really hope that, you know, we acknowledge that this habit is bad and we also try and work towards it on an everyday single basis. I mentioned this in my previous video, I'm going to mention it again. I battle it out every single day. There are some days that I come out victorious, there are some days that I literally give in and give up, but that doesn't stop me from working on it on an everyday single basis. So probably you could read a book, you could talk to someone before going to sleep, you could read something, anything. But, you know, let's try and keep our distractions away, probably 30 to 45 minutes before we go to bed. Alright guys, thank you so much for watching this video, and please stay tuned for more. Cheers.